الجنة موي جبل كل صوب تلقى خبنا مويون وجبو تيار وو مويون القرآن السنة.
الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. وبعد، بكي نيجي سانت بروم بي سبحانه وتعالى جامت كيغا خامني موم لا يالو.
الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تلا. Today we're back here again translating the statement of one of the students, Hafizahullah Ta'ala, and he is one of the students of Sheikh Muhammad, Dr. Muhammad Ahmad Hafizahullah Ta'ala, and his name is Ustaz Umar Jallo. He study with Dr. under Dr. Hafizahullah Ta'ala. First and foremost, the brother Hafizahullah Ta'ala, Umar Hafizahullah Ta'ala, he started by saying that he praised Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala as he deserved to be praised. And this is why the nun has the right to be followed and be the beneficial following, meaning a benefit following that person, like Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. He asked Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala, he thank him, praise him, and ask Allah Jalla Wa Ala to forgive us our sins, to forgive us for our sins, all of them, and protect us. And preserve us and protect us from the evil of our own soul. But indeed, we testify when we say, whoever Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala guide, he is the one that is guided. And whoever Allah has let go as astray, he is destroyed, he is misguided by Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. We testify that none has the right to be worshipped in the truth except Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala alone. And we pray in the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And we pray and ask Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala to guide whoever and bless whoever follow the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, his family and his companion until the hereafter. As for follows, we ask you and we advise you, my brothers and sisters in Islam, to fear Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala, to leave everything he orders you to leave, and to act upon everything he acted of, everything he ordered you to act upon. First and foremost, all you who believe in Allah Jalla wa Ala, know that the first thing Allah ordered the human being, the first thing Allah ordered the believers, the first order we have, the first movement, the first act we should, action we have to take over, the action, yani the first act we have to be upon, first and foremost, the mandatory things, those things that is in higher position, those things that are supposed to come first, need to come first. Those things that need to be in the head. It's to neglect, to reject, to deny every idol, everything that is an idol, as a worship, every idol. And to deny and to reject and to stay away from and to refute everything that worshipped other than Allah, everything that is worshipping, like everything that people worship other than Allah or with Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. We need to reject it. And to believe in Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala alone and worship Him alone without any partner. Not to find a partner or a son or a companion or similar. We cannot compare Allah to anything or have any somebody similar to Him or anything like that, because He doesn't have any of those. The Sunnah Hafizahullah Ta'ala, he said, as Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala, when he started talking about the belief, when Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala, he started talking about the belief system of the believers, the first thing he brought out of those beliefs is rejection. It's to reject before you take anything. Reject everything. First and foremost, Allah Jalla wa Ala start by saying to neglect, to reject, to throw away, to deny everything people worshiping other than Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. Anybody or whoever is calling upon himself or claiming that he's Allah, or they put him in a position that he's Allah Jalla wa Ala, or they put him in a position that he's similar to Allah, or anything like that.
وَيُؤْمِن بِاللَّهِ لَيْكِ نَكْ مُقَمْ يَاللَّهِ كُنْ دَنْغَيْ وَيَدِّي چَاخَان وَيَدِّي لَوْ خَمْنِي دَنْ كَوَيْ جَامُ كَدُ يَاللَّهِ وَفَرَيْ دُورُكَمْ يَاللَّهِ
First and foremost, out of all of this, everything like we just mentioned, a person for him to become a believer, he have to reject all of it. He have to throw away all of it. Then with that, he accepts Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. Then he believe in Allah Jalla Wa Ala. Then he became a believer. Then he what? He became a believer. So first and foremost, in this religion of Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala, first thing to do is to reject before you take anything.
Ngam Yalla gi doora bax. Kon Yalla weddi gi la ñeuka tambale. Kufru bi taghut gi mom la ñeuka tambale.
Then he said Hafizahullah Ta'ala, Allah Jalla Wa Ala start by rejecting before he take in affirmation. So he started by rejecting. So the belief of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, the belief of the Salaf al-Salih, is to reject those taqut, those idol worshippers, those fire worshippers, anything or anybody that is, people are worshipping, this is to be rejected. Then after that, you take and affirm the new affirmation, and that is Tawheed of Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala alone.
Moy walum gem walu tawhid sensibilité bi mu am ci jambi moy do gem lila neex wala nga weddi lula neex.
The proof and the proof of that is, as for the believers, you can take anything, believe, you can pick and choose what you want to believe or the stuff you don't want to believe, because it's sensitive, it's a thin line, it's very sensitive for the believers. You know, understand? So you can pick or choose what you want to do, what you want to believe or not. You can do that. Whatever Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala orders you to believe, those are the things that you believe. And whatever Allah Jalla Wa Ala orders you to reject, those are the things you reject as a believer. The order Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala give, reject every idol worshiper, every idol as a, you know, as your Lord, all this taqut, everything people worshiping. He said that order, you didn't pick and choose what you want to reject or affirm. Indeed, Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala choose that for you and you take it as a believer. You don't have no choice, it's an obligation for you to reject it because it's order from Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. So that's why you reject it.
Mu tek ci mu ne woy min billah nga gëm yalla kesse kon li man ndeke ngëm ci ñaar yi lay dox.
Then with that, Allah orders you to believe in him alone. So and then you take that too. So that's another order from Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. So we're just showing you to let you know that iman is with two things: rejection and affirmation.
Moy al kufru bi taghut ak al iman billah, moy da ngay rejeter lepp lo xamni dafa daxto principe bu ngëm.
He said, Hafizahullah Ta'ala, these two things that iman is built with are two conditions: to reject everything that is opposite of believing of the belief of the Muslims, Islamic belief, to reject everything that is opposite to that belief, and to take, affirm, and to accept everything that is with that belief, meaning everything that people are worshiping other than Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala, we reject all of it. And the thing that come according to Islam and the Sunnah of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and that is saying that believe this way and that way, we take those as our any way of believing.
Te lolu waxna la ne nit ku ne ya koy choisir sa bop amo ci choix lila yalla gem lo rek ngay gem lim la weddi lo ngay weddi kon ndeke ngem ci ñaar yoy lay dox legi nak li upp ci doomu adama yi ñom dañuy accepter rek iman rek lañuy def mais duñu rejeter du def kufru bi tawul
say hafizhu Allah ta'ala most of the people they always accepting but they don't have no rejection. They always accepting whatever people say to them, they take it. When you go to these black people, they're telling you that any white people are devil, and other than that, they're accepting everything they're telling them, accepting. And this is not Islam, ya akhwan. This is not Islam. The Islam of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Islam of Allah jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala, have rejection and affirmation.
To soy gem rek lu ñew nga gem da ngay gem lo warta gem benen bi it baxu di weddi rek lu ñew nga weddi da ngay weddi ba weddi lo warta weddi.
So is a level between the two. So if everything that can, you just believe in it and accepting it, so you will accept something that's supposed to be rejected. And the other way around too. So you can reject everything too. You can reject everything and anything. Because if you keep rejecting anything and everything, you might reject something that's supposed to be accepted and you will reject it. So it's a level, it's a balance. That's why Islam of Allah Jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala is a wasat. It's ummatan wasata. So is iman go by iman, the iman, the will, the two will of iman is to reject and affirm. To reject what Allah ordered you to reject and affirm what Allah ordered you to affirm.
Lolu motax lu mata baye xel motax borom bi muni ku weddi taxut gem yalla kesse koku japp na ci pass pass bu deugere bi nga xamne du fecce al urwat al wusqa.
That's the reason why Allah jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said the one who hold into this, rejecting what Allah ordered him to reject and accept what Allah ordered him to accept, he is not someone who is a loser. He is holding into a rope that is very strong, that is tight, because it's the rope of Allah jalla wa ala.
Pass pass bu deugal bobu nga xamne du fekke ko moy lan moy la ilaha illa Allah ulama wa tafsir lañ fi ri'a al-urwatul wusqa.
That way or that aqeedah or that manhaj that we claiming that it won't be neglected, it won't go away, it won't be lost, it won't be destroyed, that way, that statement, that rope is to testify and to say in the belief la ilaha illa Allah. That's a statement that is need to be accepted.
Kon sa la ilaha illallah pour mu bax nek la ilaha illallah bu wir moy da ngay weddi lila yalla weddi do gem lila yalla gem lo.
So for your la ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah to be accepted, to be the proper way, is for you to reject what Allah ordered to reject and accept what Allah ordered to accept through the way of the Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the way he brought it.
Way boy set yow ci sa bir dundu yay xol li ngay weddi yay xol li ngay gem koku baxatu parce que walu ngem bu sa ndir yalla.
Or you who believe no, that rejecting, accepting is not something that is in your hand. Belief is not in your hand. So if you're choosing in picking what you accept and what you reject, then you have messing your religion up because it's something that is not in your hand. So don't pick and choose the stuff that is yani the stuff that is with your desire, the stuff that match your desire, those belief system that match your desire, you follow them. And the stuff that bother you, that against you, that refute you, bring you down, and you reject those. So as a believer, you believe as you should believe, meaning rejection, affirmation. The same time, through only one way, the way of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because that's how Allah orders to do so.
Yalla subhanahu wa ta'ala mo lay gem lo li ngay gem mo lay weddi lo li ngay wetti comme mo lay weddi lo taxut amu ci choix da ngay weddi taxut lolu motax muni ku weddi taxut gem yalla koku japp na ci pass pass bu deugur bobu nga xamne da fecce ko yalla aji degg lu aji gis na borom bi den waxat bi ñun yalla ñun ni nañ ci peuple bu ne ci kaw suuf ab yonent.
With that, Allah jalla subhanahu in that ayah by saying Allah, he is the all here and the all seer. After that, Allah jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala said, for every nation, for every group, for every population, for every people, we send prophets to them.
وَلَقَدْ بَعَثْنَا فِي كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ رَسُولًا. People bu ne rek yoni nañ fa aw yonent lan mo taxone yalla yonu yonenti yoyu muta'allil an ya'budu muta'allil ko mune ngir ñu jaamu yalla wetal ko watani bu taagut sori ay xëdum
Allah jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala he said the reason why he send prophets for to every nation to every group, every nation believe Allah jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala is like to ask him a question why he said for them to worship me alone so they can so they won't worship any idols any worship any taqut any idols they don't worship anything or anybody else with Allah or other than Allah jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala
kon dekk li tax yalla yoni yonent yep wacce diine wacce tere lepp len la moy jami weddi xerum gem yalla ba yalla
so the reason why Allah jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala send the prophets revealed books send messengers to come guide us only one reason for us to reject all taghut anything that deserve to be anything people are worshiping or any everything people are worshiping or jinn are worshiping other than Allah jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala or with Allah jalla wa ala is not to be rejected in whole so but for us to worship Allah jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala alone that's the condition and that's the reason why Allah jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala sent us down here That's the reason why he brought the books down. That's the reason why he sent the prophets and messengers down.
Di yoon yonent yalla noor ba ci yoon yalla Muhammad cause principal bi gëna mag ci mission yonent yi mo doonon fexé ba ñi xam luy taawut wéddi ko fexé ba xam kan moy yalla gëm bu diñ ko wutal morom ak ndem
Since the prophet Nuh alayhi salatu wassalam to the prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam Allah jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala he was sending prophets and messengers and all of them the biggest reason again the big of reason the biggest reason Allah send them is for us to worship Allah jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala alone without any partner
lol motax muni wala qad ba'athna fi kulli ummatin rasula an ya'budu Allah wa tanibu ta'ud yalla muni ya yonent yoy biñ ñewé di wéddi lo nit ñi xërem di len gëm yalla nit ñi dañu sédduliko ñaari groupe minhum
he said hafizahullah ta'ala When the prophets come and calling the people to the way, to the right path, to calling them to Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala, people are divided into two types. People are divided into two groups. From them.
Man had Allah. Am na tini yalla jubal, ni top wakhu yana tiya. Kham lui khiram, am kudasu ak fitu nyama kawweti.
He say from them are those who Allah give the mercy, who Allah has blessed for them to understand and know. The danger of committing shirk, the danger of having a partner with Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala, the danger of worshiping other than Allah Jalla Wa Ala, and Allah has guided them, and Allah has blessed them. So them, for them to believe in that, and know it, and have the power, and have the strength, and have the belief in their hearts to reject it in their heart and in public too.
Xam ku yalla am fulla ak sañ sañu gëm ko bañ ko bolé ak lenen ñoñu minhum man hada Allah wa minhum man haqqat alayhi ad-dalala
so they have the strength to reject it had the strength to stay away from it Allah has blessed them with that and they knew about it because Allah jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala give them the chance to know about it and the other people from them are those
ñoo xamni reer gi dafa yell ci ñoom parce que paré wuñ pour weddi xërem paré wuñ tamit pour gëm yalla kessé bañ ko bolé dara
From the second group, from them, they deserve to be lost because they're not ready. They're not ready to reject and deny to worship other than Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Taala. They want to worship Allah with Allah Jalla. They want to worship Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Taala with their idols, or they want to worship other than Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Taala. So with them is misguidance. With them is destruction. With them is dalala.
mujjantelu ñaan wedd yalla ci kaw suuf yalla jaar ñoo bayyi na fi ay effet seeni effet ak jeexintal yo xamne bo ci xole mën nga ci jang
asu Allah jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala he say look and see those who disbelieve and deny Allah jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala look Allah left signs meaning signs for us believers to see that those who disbelieve in Allah jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala Allah has punished them Allah has destroyed them
borom bi del wax ni yalla du jéggelé ñukoy bokalé dar waye lu dul bokalé yalla dina ko jéggel ci nga xamné mom moko sopp ku bokalé yalla nak yalla mu né sanku nga sanku def bir
أفرزوا الله جل سبحانه وتعالى. He said الله جل وعلا He won't forgive and He don't forgive those who come in partner with Him. Allah just won't forgive that. But those who come with sins other than shirk, other than partnership with Allah جل وعلا, Allah forgives all of it. Allah جل سبحانه وتعالى forgives all of it. That's the reason why He said those who commit shirk, those who have partnership with Allah جل سبحانه وتعالى, those who worship Allah جل وعلا with other, who worship other than Allah جل وعلا, Allah جل سبحانه وتعالى say about them that they are lost, they are destroyed, they are misguided. Allah said they are destroyed, a way that is not of, a way that is far away from the truth, a way that destruction.
Kenn ci borom xam mu ne melokan bi ñuy wéndé tawul moy ga daal di fas ci pass pass bu deugër ne lu ñuy jaamu te du yalla neen chaaxat.
A way of rejecting a tawut other Allah jalla wa ala, a way of rejecting the false is to say and believe in your heart that anything, anybody or anything that people or jinn are worshipping other than Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala is falsehood, is batil, is falsehood, and you don't benefit. And you don't have no doubt about that at all. There's no doubt about that. And to leave it alone and to free yourself away from those people who do that and itself. To free you away from that worship, that shirk, that false worship, and the people that claims it and the people that worship it.
And the
belief that Allah is talking about is to believe all type of beliefs, all type of ibadah, of worship, all type of action of worship. All type of love, all type of worship, only Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala deserve it alone. He is the one that deserves it alone. So is for Him alone. So whoever else people are doing it for, or whoever else people are doing it for, he doesn't deserve it. This is the belief that you're supposed to have. He doesn't deserve it. So we say then, if Allah Jalla wa'ala is the only one that deserves to be worshipped alone, and you know it and you believe it in your heart, that all the worship belongs to Allah Jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, and reject anything, any other worship that people are doing other than Allah Jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala, then if it's that, minimize, meaning shrink, and get to a point to know that all the worship belong to Allah alone. All the worship. Shrink all of it and say all of it belongs to Allah Jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. So if you shrink it, it won't be no room for you to put somebody else in there because it's
going to
be tight. So then with that, you won't share the right that Allah Jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala deserve alone. You won't share and give to other Allah Jalla wa ta'ala. You only give to Allah Jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala alone.
Nga bëgg jaamu yalla wétal yalla gi bëgg ñi nekk ci wétal yalla bañ bokalé bañ ñi nekk ci bokalé ba faras.
Then with that, it's for you in your aqeedah and your manhaj to love those who act upon this, to love those who worship Allah Jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, to love the people of it and to love the worship, and to hate those who commit shirk, those who find partnership with Allah Jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala, to hate them and the action they do.
Sept ñom mu ne lolou mom moy yoonu yoon ci Ibrahim bi nga xamne yalla wax na yoonu Ibrahim bobu kep ku ko bayyi muy nek ci tawhid sori xeurum kep ku ko bayyi yang ci sankute nek nga ko xamni da nga manke.
That's the reason why that way of loving the people of the people of the haq, the truth, and hating the people of the falsehood, the people of dalala, that way is the way of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam. That way was the way that Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam was upon. That's the reason why whoever believe ta'ghut, idol worshippers, and reject the haq, the truth, he will falsehood. Yani he is misguided. He is destroyed.
توحيد العبادة موي ويتال يالله تي جامو كو لول مو دون ميسيون يونتي لي نكو واخ بوروم بي نينا
is that is a tawhid of worship to ask to worship Allah jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala the way is order that is to worship Allah jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala the way he ordered us to do so
bo de suratul a'raf yalla tud nafa juroom yonent yo xamne kenn ku ci nek bam deme day wax nitam ne len ya qawmi ibudullaha ma lakum min ilahin ghayru yel sama nit jamu len yalla kott jamu len yalla kesse bu len ko bokale len
as reason why when you go to the surah just mention he say you're going to find 5 prophets and messenger 5 prophet and messenger Allah jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned them and with them and each one of them say to his people worship Allah jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala alone and don't worship nobody other than him don't find or put any partnership with him Allah jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala because he deserves to be worshiped alone Allah sent all prophets to say that
kon nit ki fogg mu set ci bokale yalla ci ñetti anam yep nit ki da cey wara set
he say then as far as the person you need to be free and clean away from shirk from partnership with Allah jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala all the three ways
moy set ci bokale yalla ci sa pass fexé ba sa pass to ci bokale yalla manam sa ngeum
first one is to free and to be free away from having partnership meaning committing shirk in your heart in your belief in your aqeedah in your manhaj you don't commit no shirk in it is no shirk in your aqeedah or your manhaj the belief system is no shirk in it free away from shirk
set ci bokale yalla ci say wax bokale du ci tabbi waye set ci bokale yalla ci say act say jop
to free yourself away from shirk from your statement free your statement you have to be free away from shirk from partnership with Allah jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala from worshiping Allah with other than Allah worshiping other than Allah jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala and the last one
doti bokale yalla parce que bokale yalla ci ñetti anam yoy so wa mu doon ngeum pass pass bo xass wala wax yoy wax wala jëf yoy def at yoy posé
the last one is your action you cannot commit shirk with your action because your action has to be free away from shirk so know that these three are combined you cannot worship Allah jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala with other than Allah jalla wa ala because your belief system your aqeedah your manhaj had to be free away from shirk your statement the statement you mentioning has to be free away from shirk and your action has to be free away from shirk
dom adamay da fexé ba ñett yi mu set ci bu ci sété koku moy ki soru ci gëm yalla go xamné ku mu sekk la mo teŋku ci ngëm gu wër koku moy ki nga xamné moy jundu batu la ilaha illa dunin go xamné gu wër na
with that a person have to be upon this his belief have to be upon this his aqeedah and his statement and his action all have to be accurate and they have to be accurate to Quran and Sunnah when a person have this then he is the one that is acting upon Quran and Sunnah he is the one that is life he is living his life acting the kalimatu la ilaha illallah muhammadur rasulullah this is the authentic belief this is the true belief
lolu motax yunus ta'ala ibrahim lolu defot motax bokale domu adam bi amu ci choix fogu nga
that's the reason why this is what the prophet ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam did that's why shirk becoming partner with allah jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala the believer doesn't have no choice about that the believer he don't have no choice about that
jël ci position ci bokale ak bokale kat koku yalla mo lako sant ibrahim
that's the reason why you have to take your position about those who commit shirk those who come in partnership with Allah jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala and that shirk itself that's the reason why Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam
ajim bi aw nitam di bokale bëgg ko xëc def pexé bu nek pour mu dik fa dem ba tollu ben niveau bo xamni dafa jël distance ak ñom yalla daf ko wax ne ko nak
that's the reason why Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam when he was upon this when he was with his people and they were pulling him they was calling him to worship other than Allah jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala one moment it became a time that he have to distance himself from them he have to separate himself away from them that's the reason why
ponga jël position bu leer parce que digënté ki gëm yalla ak bokale kat waru ñu leen di mélanger dañ
that's the reason why you have to take a clear position between the person that commit partner with Allah jalla wa ala and the person that worship Allah jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala the way he supposed to be worshiped then it's supposed to be a big difference We cannot compare them because they are not the same. They are not the same and they are not equal. Indeed, the one who worships Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala alone, he is much, much, he is way better than the other one. The other one destroyed. He is destroyed. He is lost.
Ibrahim nalen man nak yalla na muhammad fatalikul bi ibrahim di wax aw nitam ko is qal.
That's the reason why Ibrahim said to his people, that's the reason why Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala said to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, remember when Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam was say to his people,
Ibrahim li qawmihi li abeehi wa qawmihi ki papam la tambali ak aw nitam nalen innani bara'un mimma ta'budun dama set wekki lepp lu ngeen di yaw.
First and foremost, Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, he say to his people, to his father and his people, and remember he started with his father. He start with his father. So you believe the da'wah of the anbiya, the da'wah of the messenger of the messengers, start with those who are closer to you. Start with those who are near to you. So he start with his father. He say, and his people, I am free away from everything you worship other than Allah Jalla wa Ala. Everything you worship other than Allah, I'm free away from it. But if Ibrahim was about to stop over there alone, only that, then it won't be clean. Then it won't be good. Then it won't be enough. Then it won't be sufficient. Because what they worship, what they was doing is with Allah. They were worshiping others with Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. They wasn't worshiping other like anything. Like they wasn't worshiping an idol alone. They wasn't worshiping a fire alone, or the moon alone, or the idols alone. They wasn't doing that alone. They was doing that with Allah Jalla wa Ala. So Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, from understanding the tawhid of Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, if he was about to stop there, then it would be a problem. Because why? Because he says to them, I am free away from everything you're worshipping. Everything you're worshipping. Remember, they used to worship. With that, it was Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. With their worship, it was Allah. So they have Allah and a partner. They worship Allah with something else. So Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, he said, I'm free away from everything you're worshipping.
Mora Ibrahim dadi accepted. Mune illa alladhi fatarani. Lulul yalla bima bind man.
That's why Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, from understanding that, he said, except Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, the one that created me, the one that made me and made you. Indeed, the reason why I'm worshipping him, because he is the one that guide me. He is the one that what? That guide me, that show me. Because it's not the other idols, it's not the other gods, it's not the other people or other thing that you're worshipping saying is Allah. None of them.
Dafa def déclaration jël position ne len ma setna wécc ci lepp lu ngeen di jaamu luddul yalla bima sak.
That's the reason why Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, he put his declaration and he speak his position. He say to them, I am free away from everything and anything you're worshiping except Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, the one that created me, the one that made me.
Do mu nek lo xamne position leer na nekul position bo xamne bu ful la.
That's the reason why that position, his choice, the word he picked is very clear. It's not something that is blurry. It's not something that is unclear. Indeed, it's sufficient because it's clear. Because he says to them, I'm free away from every and anything you're worshiping except Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala alone. So he's showing you that they used to worship other things with Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala.
Ci waxat borom bi tay netali wat batay Ibrahim ak onitam gëna jëlat distance mu ne len wa a'tazilukum wa ma tad'una min dunillah bis ni ki tay setna ci yeen sori na len.
With that, Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, he didn't stop over there. With that, he took another position. Indeed, he make his distance far away from them. He said to them, I'm free away from you, and I separate myself with you. We're not the same anymore. I am free away and I distance myself away from you and in everything that you worship other than Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala.
Bokale ak bokale kat da ngay jël ci mom distance.
So shirk, to worship other than Allah and the people that does it, you stay away from them. You have to have distance away from them because that's the tawhid of Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. That's the order from Allah Jalla wa Ala.
Dur motax kon yalla daal di wax lolu motax yalla ne nekkal na len royu kay bu rafet. Qad kanat lakum uswatun hasana fi Ibrahim.
That's the reason why Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala say, he sent a beautiful example for them. And that was Ibrahim. Ibrahim was an example for them. He's supposed to copy from him. Became a beautiful example. Ibrahim has become a beautiful example for you, for the ummah, for the people, and the people that he was with the people and the people that he was with.
Ibrahim ñimu nekkalon position bobu ñim ci bokkalon nek mo yonent yalla yep lool mo doon sen position.
And that position that Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala said, that position Ibrahim took and the people that was with him on that position, that's the position of all the prophet, all the messengers. All the prophet messengers have the same position, so they are a beautiful example for us.
Bañi wax sew nit ne len inna buraa minkum mimma ta'budu, set nañ rek ci yeen parce que da ngeen di bokkal yalla, set nañ rek ci yeen ci lepp lu ngeen di jaamu te yalla.
That's the reason why they say we are free away from you and everything you worship other than Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. Be free away from everything and anything you worship other than Allah Jalla wa Ala.
Tek ci ne len weddi nañ len tes ak nono doxna suñu digënté ak yeen ak nono doxna suñu digënté ak yeen ba ket rom ngeen di del ci waat di gëm yalla kesse.
He say we free away and we separate, we free ourselves away from you and we separate ourselves away from you and we became enemies. And we became your enemies until you return to the truth. So now, the enmity in the Islamic religion, in Islam, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is aqidah and manhaj, is the belief system. So if they are not believers, they are your enemies by Allah.
Why sorry accept yi li nga xamne moy bokale.
Oh, you who believe in Allah Jalla wa Ala, this ayah of Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala is strength the believers to hold and to worship Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala alone, to abide with his motif, to worship Allah Jalla wa Ala alone, and to free yourself away from shirk and become the enemy of the people of shirk. This ayah, that's the benefit behind it, and is
fiyete ni to way sorry li nga xamne mom moy nitu bokale yi ak deñ ci ñom ba set lecc.
And that is to be friend and to be with the people that commit to be with the people that worship Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, who commit the right, who choose the right path, who take the right choices, is to worship Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala the way he deserves to be worshipped, the way he's supposed to be worshipped, and to become the enemy and to free away from you from you shirk and his people.
Parce que nak kep ko xamne mi ngi tabbi ci bokale koke dafa bayyi tawhid.
Why? So no, anybody that enter shirk, anybody that choose or worship other than Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, he left tawhid alone.
Kep ko xamne ngoy na tawhid ba jeex ci koke bayyi na bokale.
So whoever hold on to tawhid, to worship Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala alone, he free himself away from worshiping other than Allah. He is free away from what's been other Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. He's on the right path.
Boki yalla wax ci benen place ci alquran leral ci alquran ci ay ay yu bari ci place yu bari ne dine l'islam ñaari ñoko fondé liko
Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, he mentioned in many places in the Quran that his religion of Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, this religion of Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala is founded by two things. The two things that found the religion are two. The things that found the religion are two.
Fondé moy gëm yalla diko jaamu waye set ci bokale ak bokale kat.
First one is to reject the shirk, the partnership with Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, to reject disbelief in Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, and to accept believe in Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, and that is the tawhid of Allah Jalla wa Ala.
Lolu ci ay bëre bëri rek ma ci Al-Qur'an Karim. Fété المؤمنون دافع نيوم موالات واي داف البراءه ست اك المعادا كي ليغا خامني موي بوكاله كاتي اك نيغا خامني دونا ويد يالا.
And that is to be friends and to be cool and to take them as family, to take them as your family, because indeed a believer, his believing brother or sister is his family. To take them on your side, to take them as your friends, to take them as your family, to take them as your partner, and to free yourself away from the shirk, the people of shirk, the people like it,
The people who commit partnership with Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. Because it doesn't matter how, it doesn't mean how close they are to you. Indeed, they are your enemy. Because they are enemy of Islam.
Borom bi waxna ne yonnati bi alayhi salatu wassalam ne ko waxal wa ahlul kitab muy jifi ak chrétien yi ne len ñew len ci baat bo xamni dañ ci wara yem ñu ñep ñoo ci yem baat ñoo ci yem
that is why Allah jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala he say to the people of the book, say to them, come to a statement, come to a claim, come to something that we all are equal in it, come to something. So all this sitting that people are having with the Jews and Christians, with the Catholic, the Muslims and the Catholic and whoever is sitting, all this meeting they're having, debating about who's right, who's wrong, Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala, he did not all that. He said to them, come to something that we all are equal in it as one. We all are one in it. I'm not better than you in it, and you are not better than me in it. And that is to worship Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala alone, without any partner. To worship Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala alone, without any partner. We all equal in this. If you are fire worshippers, idol worshippers, you're a magician, a sorcery, you don't believe in anything, a parties, whatever you are, come to this. Come to worshiping Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala alone, without any partner, then we all will be equal. And do not take people from us. Do not take people from you. And worship them and put them in the place and position of Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. Because they are not. There's nothing but a creation just like you. As when Allah ordered him this, Allah say, if they can accept it and they believe, Alhamdulillah, then that's good. If they don't believe and then accept, your believers continue. Stay in the journey. Keep on that path. Don't get off that path. Because Allah is with you. You're on the right path.
Okay. Nyari duñu dajé. Ñom ñaar duñu dajé. Muy tawhid ak bokale. Ñom ñaar buñu dajé.
So know that tawhid of Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala and shirk, they cannot go together. They can't meet because they are enemies. They will fall apart. Like they will fight. There's a war between the two. So they can never meet. They can never meet.
Tawhid da fi nek bokale da yonam.
Tawhid will stay and the shirk and partnership with Allah will remove.
Bokale ne fi tawhid da yonam.
Oh, shirk will be here and tawhid will be removed. So either or, they cannot be in the same spot again.
Bokale da yonam. Ñaari duñu dajé duñu fekkante. Lolu motax nit ki fogg mu xol ban la ci japp te julit bi tawhid moy lako borom bi subhanahu wa ta'ala ta di sant.
So you believe You have to choose and pick what you want to take. And the order we have from Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala is the Tawhid of Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. Worship Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala alone. So this is the order from our Lord Jalla Wa'ala. So as a believer, Tawhid is our order.
Lu motax Yalla wax na ci akwa yi nga xamne da fay bokale. Mu ne doomu adama bi bu fekke lor tabbi na ci kawam day wo boromam delu ci mom xamne boromam moy Yalla yi deug.
As is the way Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala was talking about the rights of worshiping Him alone. He said when a person make a mistake, when a person commit a sin, he go back to Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala and repent. And know that the worship deserves to Allah Jalla Subhanahu
Wa Ta'ala alone.
May Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala, when the person is in trouble, when the person doesn't know what he's doing, at that moment, he started worshiping Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala alone, without any partner. So, when Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala removed all the hardship, all his problem, he go back to worshiping other than Allah Jalla Wa Ta'ala. He was go back to worship other than Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala.
Lolu mune da koy def mutal Yalla ay morom di sank ay nit ba pare sanku ci yoon yi mu nek. Yalla ne ko nak kuy def lolu nural di xewulu ci mbugal mo xamni mo lay xaar.
So he acted upon this. Then whoever is doing this and he's on that path and he's taking people with them in that path. Allah Jalla Wala said, whoever is doing this type of stuff, swim and be deep into the destruction, into a path, a way that is a way of destruction. Because you don't have nothing with Allah Jalla Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala but the hellfire in the hereafter.
bokki kon weddi lepp lu ñuy jaamu tan yalla ak lepp lu bëgg tek place am yalla ak kuñ bëgg tek place yalla lolé dafa jaamu ci wéte ko yalla bi pour tawhid am nek tawhid go xamné bu mat la
or you believe so to deny and reject anything or anybody everything that people are looking to worship or putting them in a position or place as Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, that is a must for a believer to reject it. It's a must for a believer to reject it.
Nyaara ba moy set ci bokale ak sori sorel say jaamu yalla lepp lo xamne bokale la.
The second one is to free yourself away from shirk, from the people of it, and to take all your worship and all your action of ibadah, all your action of worship, to be free away from worshiping other than Allah Jalla wa Ala.
At baña am ben tolérance ci bokale parce que Yalla amu ci tolérance.
And not to have any excuse or any feelings or any shortcoming or any if about shirk, because Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, He is not easy with shirk. Indeed, He is harsh with shirk. So all you who believe, be harsh with shirk.
Kon waro ci am tolérance. Lolu motax kon tawhid du mat mukk dudul ci ñaar yoyu te lolu moy diina yenenti lolu
la that's the reason why your tawhid will never be complete except the two. Your tawhid will never be sufficient without the two, and this was the religion of the prophet and messengers.
En waron li nga xamne moy seen nit borom bi neena ci danger vocale ak li meuna jural ak population ak société li meuna jural doomu adama bi en tant qu'individu yalla mi ngi koy netali.
And this was the call a prophet messenger was calling their people upon, in the danger, and the danger again, the evil and the danger of committing shirk, the evil that they can bring to the people, to the community, to the population, to the nation, to the groups, the evil of it.
Suratul Ahqaf ci ki nga xamne mom moy yaronti Allah mu ne yaronti Allah Muhammad wazkur fatalikun akha adin sambokuma
and that is what as Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala said in Surah Al-Ahqaf to the brother of our prophet, our prophet Hud alayhi salatu wasalam. Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala said to the prophet, remember your brother, remember the prophet. To his people, remember to your brother. When we sent him to his people, and that was the people of God, he said to them,
dafa ñew war aw nitam di len kuppu bil ahqaf ci mbugal mo xamni man na tabbi ci seeni tol ak seeni xur yalla mu ne
he is come and start warning them, he start warning his people, he start warning his nation, he start warning them about a punishment that can come and destroy their farms, destroy their houses, destroy their crave, destroy them all.
Waqat khalat an-nuzur min bayni yadayhi min khalfihi te lu jitu saxu yonent yalla hud ay warata jaron na fi jitu ginaaw gi ay warata sax dinañu wat ci ginaaw.
And before that, before the prophet Hud alayhi salatu wassalam came, it was other prophet that was over there, there was over people that was over there calling them, advising them and calling them to the truth. And after him too, it will be over than him. It'll be other people that will come, advising these people and advising them and calling them to the haqq and telling them what to do.
Te lepp ñoom ñep lañu nara bokk diko wax moy Allah ta'budu illa Allah bu len jaamu kenn ku dul yalla.
And all of them together, they have one similar thing, one thing in common, and then don't worship nothing but Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala alone. Don't worship anything other than Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala alone.
Lan motax inni akhafu alaykum adhab yawmin adheem su ngeen fi jaamo keneen ko dul yalla damay ragal mbugal mu mag yalla wacce ko sen kaw.
The reason behind it, don't worship nothing but Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, because if you worship something with Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, or you worship other than Allah Jalla wa Ala, a punishment, a big punishment might come. Allah might send a punishment, a great punishment upon you.
Ñom lan lañ tontu yonent yalla ko qalu ñu ne ko ajitana yow da nga dikki ci ñun dikana an alihatina pour détourner ñu ñu bayyi suñu yalla ci.
Then they say to our prophet, to the brother of our prophet, because every prophet as a Muslim They believe in every prophet and messenger. If they say to our prophet, Hud alayhi salatu wasalam, you're just rejecting us. You're just making us turn away from the way of our forefathers. You're just taking us away from our gods.
Lolu mo la taxaju kon nak fatina bima ta'iduna gis nga ki faible doomu adam bu nek ci position bu faible toujours moy ñeuk menacer.
So after they say that, they say, you know, all you're trying to do is make us stop worshiping our God. And he said, Hafizahullah Ta'ala, the person who is wrong, the person in the weak side all the time, he's the person that first attack. He is weak. He always trying to attack. He is very weak because he just sees that he don't have no good stand. So he has to attack.
Neko faqtina bima ta'iduna ci histoire bi yeb Hud waxagu len lul dama ragal ci yeen am bugul waxu len yalla day wacce ci yeen am bugul dama ko ragal ci yeen.
They have shown you that the people that don't then aqeed and then manhaj is not correct, they are scared and they don't have no stance. And to right now Hud didn't tell them that punishment will come to you. He said, I am scared, I'm afraid that if you don't stop, Allah will send the punishment.
Ñu ne ko yow da nga ñew ku dëtt na ñu bayyi suñu xërëm bayyi wuñ ko té légui wa mugal mi ngay wax na ñew.
They say, you calling us to worship, to stop worshiping our idols, our gods? No, we're not. Matter of fact, the punishment you talking about, it might come. Let it come. We're ready for it. Let that punishment come because our gods will do something about it.
Fatina bima ta'iduna in kunta min as-sadiqin. Mugal mi na waat bu fekke yow li ngay wax dëgg la.
They say to him, to our prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, send the punishment. Let your God send the punishment if what you saying is true.
Qala innamal ilmu 'inda Allah. Mu len walum bugal xawma ci dara, yalla koy wacce moy duma ku ko neex.
La ilaha illallah. Look at the prophet and the messengers. When he say this, look what he replied. He said, as far as punishing and blessing and stuff like that, that's even Allah jalla wa ala. I don't know nothing about that. I'm only a warner. To worship and stuff like that, I don't have nothing to do with that. That is the power. That's with Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala.
Ay man lima xam moy lima Yalla wax. Uballighukum ma ursiltu bih. Lima Yalla yon ni lay jotani.
But me, what I know is what Allah told me. And what Allah tell me to pass, like messenger to pass me to give, that's what I'm giving. I don't know nothing but that.
Lima Yalla yon mom lay jotani. Walakinni araakum qauman tajhadun. Tay yen dama gis ni da ngay ne reer te nu ci grekh.
Indeed, what I'm seeing and what I'm looking at is you are destroyed, you are misguided, and you're deep in it. Meaning, you're destroyed, yeah, and you have a deep loss. You believe in this destruction very deep.
Dengan rir bunuh cikrir. Falamma ra'ahu aridan mustaqbil awdiyatihim, qalu hadha aridun mumtiruna. Jeki, gis abnir. Yalla, khinan abnir bamyukuk, dokh jem si kisen kurwinyak.
Then with that, while they had all of this type of stuff, while they were sitting over there, while they having an argument, while they was doing that, Allah Jalla wa Ala, he sent a darkness from the sky. It looked like a rain about to come. They looked at it, it looked like a rain about to come down, and it come straight towards them, to their city, to their town, to their side.
Dibi ñew ñu gis ko ñom ñu ne li dal ab niir la bo xamni yalla ko indi pour mu tim ñu pour sorti fi xewal sorti fi ndox mo xamni day dindi décor bi nga xamne ñun mom lañ doon dund.
With them and they saw that, they saw this right here, you know, our God sent this down for us. It's a blessing that will come, so a rain with blessing will come and will benefit us and bless us, so all of this all this drop we have will go away, so this rain will come and bless us and benefit us.
Ak xit bi nga xamne mom lañ nekké lolu bimu amé yon ci yalla hu tonk len mune bal huwa mastaajaltum bih du niir wuy indi xewalu taw rek de waye yeen sakku mbugal li.
Indeed, when they saw that, they say this is a rain that will come and bring blessing. It's something that will come bless us and benefit us. And the prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, indeed, this is not a blessed rain. You're seeking for punishment, and that's the punishment about to come. You are begging for it, and Allah is bringing it. Remember, they say, if you are truthful, then let your God bring the punishment.
dafa and ak fay and ak ngelaw lo xamne ngelaw lolou mugal mu tar mo ci nek.
With that thing look like a rain. With it is a wind that is a very very severe wind, and it's part of slave of Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. It come with a punishment to destroy and punish those people over there.
Kum ni ko yalla waxe ci suratul ahqaf ngelaw lo xamne jurom ñaari guddi yo xamni ngelaw lay ngelaw sen kaw tobu ci taw sen kaw.
As Allah said in suratul ahqaf, it's like 7 days, 7 nights. Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala said, the rain is coming down and the heavy wind is coming with them. Why they over there? 7 days.
Fara yagum ko munetu damiru kull shay'in bi amri rabbiha. Ngelaw lo xamne bu ñewé lepp lay map lepp lay danel ci li nga xamne moy ndigolu borom. Yalla mu
With that rain come with the order to destroy and deny and buruk and everything with the order of his Lord. That rain destroyed and wind destroyed everything. Allah Jalla Subhanahu orders to destroy.
Da bangelaw la amé bu paré fa asbatu la yura illa masakinuhum. Han bangelaw lu ñëwé bayyi wu fa dara gisatuñ ko luy nit dudul seen dekk way rek moko dess té dekk way nit yëlon ci Allah di tax daanuul dama tafsir ñu ko wala tax daanuul moy ahqaf yi dekkol.
And when the rain come, it will leave nothing and nobody over there but the buildings. Everybody was destroyed. The only thing that was left over there was a building. He said, and the reason why the building wasn't destroyed is because the ulama of tafsir, they said, they was living in the place like the mountains of rocks. So they used to cut their houses in that rocks. It's like a side, a mountains of rocks. So they used to build their houses inside the mountains. But if it was houses and the buildings, it would be destroyed. It won't be there.
Ay montagne yu am ay pax la ñepp dëkk loolu motax yalla daane lu montagne.
Because they where they used to live at, where they used to stay at, it's like a mountains, but they have holes in it. They used to dig a hole and make it as their houses.
Way lepp lu fay nit ak garab borom bi daal di koy fagaagal.
But anything that was out there, as far as a tree or human being, Allah destroys it. Or you who believe, no, these people was powerful. They used to dig inside the mountains to build their houses. How about you who are weak, who can even do nothing for yourself?
Kéri rek la fa bay. Yalla mu ne kazalika najzil qawmal mujrimin. Ñun de ni lañuy fayé nit ñoo xamni dañoo kaccoré. Ca ka
Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala say, this is how we pay those who are the wrongdoers, those who are misguided. This is how we pay them, because we order them to worship me alone and they worship other than Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. So they get paid an evil payment. The evilest of evil is to commit shirk with Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. Or you will believe. Shirk destroyed and broke and take away from every good thing you do. From every good you did before. Shirk destroyed. The small of it and the big of it and the small of it. So stay away from it. Shirk in general.
Yalla du nangul ci bokkal kat bi ben jëf ju baax du mu def du ko nangul julli farafa du ko nangul nafila du ko nangul saraxe du ko nangul digle lu baax du ko nangul tere lu bon.
Allah Jalla wa Ala, he don't accept nothing, any small thing from the person that commits shirk with him. He doesn't accept your salat, he doesn't accept your zakat, he doesn't accept your charity, he doesn't accept your good doing, he doesn't accept nothing from you. Nothing from you.
Du ko nangul len lo xamne yiwu borom bi neena ñi weddi.
Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala accept nothing that is good from you. Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala said,
yalla bokale ko dañuy dajale seeni jëf bu ñëwé bañ won len ko bañ gis ko ci manuta yalla su ko defé ñu doon walal ko mu doon gelaw da gi def.
Allah Jalla wa Ala said, those who used to come and partner with shirk with him, those who used to worship Allah with other, those who worship other than Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, in the hereafter, they will be brought forward, and all the action that they did before will be brought forward, and they will look at it, and Allah will make the wind blow it. It will go a vain. Meaning, it will be destroyed. The wind will take it.
Qur'an bi delu waxat, Yalla wahyuna la yow Muhammad, ak yonent yi lay jitu won, su ngeen ma bokalé won ma mabbu seeni jëf ku su ngeen ñëwé yamal xiyam perte
Allah jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala say o Muhammad you and the people before you and you and the people that we send yani we send you to if you was prophet messengers if you was about to worship Allah if you was about to worship with Allah or other than Allah jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala anything you will be destroyed and if you come in the hereafter you'll be a loser meaning or you prophet and messengers if you was about to commit any part any shirk with Allah jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala you'll be destroyed in this dunya and the hereafter you will come and you'll be a loser and you'll be punished
yalla wax batay ci yonentami mune li moy njubu yalla topulen yalla
that's the reason why Allah jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala he said to his prophet this is the guidance of Allah jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala then follow it this is the guidance of Allah jalla wa ala then follow it
moy jubal ku ko neex ci ay jama
Allah guide whoever he will from his creation
dhalika hudallah yahdi bihi man yasha min ibadihi walau ashraku la habita ankum ma kanu ya'malun su ngeen bokale won yeen yonenti sama bu li nga xal dum moy seenu jëf bokki
if the prophet messengers was about to worship Allah jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala with other than him to commit any shirk all their action will be destroyed all their worship will be destroyed as Allah jalla wa ala said
bokku ci li metti xol gi daw yaram nek danger bu mak bo xamne mi ngi xaar julit ni ak seeni societe di menacer li gëna cher li ñu am muy tax
you believe from the biggest danger from the biggest thing we have with us the biggest danger the most scary thing are those things that will destroy everything you built are those things that will change and break your life everything
moy tassare bokale
and that is to separate I need to publish or to emphasize in committing shirk or to publish the people like it or to be friends with them or to be cool with them or to help them
tassare bokale
and spreading shirk then to spread partnership with Allah jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala that is destruction
el grave yalla diko jox ay nit
to take the right of Allah jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala and give it to other than him
nit ñi na tek beli dara xew
and people are quiet like nothing happening
lolu mi ngi menacer li gëna reey nit ñi am seen diine
that is warning against the biggest thing they have about in the religion the biggest thing they have in the religion is the tawhid so that is weakening their tawhid
ay wetal yalla ak li yalla mom ñu baye ko bañ ko nang ci mom diko jox keneen ko dul mom
So all the right Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala deserve alone. Everything that belongs to Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala alone, let Allah have it. Give it to Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala alone without any partner.
Bokk na ci mbokki li nga xamne ay nonu l'islam ñing koy tassare ci ay media yu ñuy lire, yu ñuy sétan ak yu ñuy dégg. Te lepp djiblu way ba moy sikki sakalo julit ñi ci seen diine.
From it are those things that enemy of Islam they spreading. From it is those things that is reading meaning is the newspapers or books or whatever it might be or the radio the talk and all this other stuff or the TV the stuff that people are seeing and stuff all these computers internet and all this other stuff and everything and this is the enemy of Islam they're doing it only for the reason the purpose behind it is to destroy the Muslims to destroy the people of Islam to destroy the people of Islam to make them enemies That's the only reason why they don't.
Dem bali grawon ci sen diine waxone dafa graw ñu banaliser ko mu nekk lu banal lu woyof
dotu and all of this is going to lead to everything that the religion used to say this is the danger this is to be scary this to for the, like it was a problem for them to be cool with that and to be around it not to like everything that was to be a danger will be light for them now it will be light for them
danger boyo bo ci wax sax dañ lay jappé ku taram
Every danger that Islam says is a danger, when you start talking about it, they thinking like something is wrong with you.
Or they look at you bizarre, parce que mbir mi.
Or they look at you like you are a weird person because the thing.
Ñing koy wax ci media, bo dañ ko woyofal nekatu lu danger.
They talking about it in the media, in the radio, in the TV, in the books, until it's light now. They don't think it's a problem. Everybody thinking it's okay, it's cool. You're talking about it, they think something's wrong with you. You are weird. You're talking about something that is nothing. It's light. With that, no, that is danger. What Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala warned against, that's something you need to be warned against. What Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala says is big, is something that is big because He's the one that created us. Whatever that was haram in the Prophet and the Messenger was here, it will be haram until the hereafter. What Allah Jalla Subhanahu wa Ta'ala ordered His Prophet to make haram, it will be haram until the hereafter. Whatever was haram will be haram until the hereafter, and whatever that is allowable will be allowable until the hereafter. It doesn't matter how many people write about it, or talk about it, or what TV publish it, or what radio publish it, it will be haram until the hereafter. It doesn't matter how many people talk about it, it's always will be haram. It doesn't matter how many TV show they have about it, or how many talk show they have about it, or how many light things they have about it, it won't make it light. It will never make it light. Because Allah Jalla wa Ala, He is the one that said it's big. So the thing that is big with Allah Jalla wa Ala is always will be big. Because whatever was big with Allah Jalla wa Ala is always will be big and major with Allah Jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala. And whatever was small with Allah Jalla wa Ala will always be small and minor to Allah Jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala. It will never change.
Okay. Kon lepp luy sikki sakku lo julli ci sen diine wala tax di woyofal sen ngeum wala lo xamni day tax li danger won ci ñoom ñu japp ne danger won.
So you believe whatever bring doubts to your religion, or whatever bring danger to your religion, or whatever bring the stuff that it was dangerous, the stuff that was scaring your religion, to make it light, to make it like less scaring, to make it easy, to make it like nothing, those things you need to stay away and warn against it and stay away from it. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to warn anything that led to shirk. Anything that led to shirk, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to warn about it. So nothing can make us return back to the haq. Nothing can bring us back to the right path, except what we said earlier. And that is, to return back to the tawheed of Allah Jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala, the right way. To know who is your creation and who is the creation and who is the creator. Who created you and who is the creation with you. The creator and the creation, you gotta put a big difference between the two. You have to be the difference between the two, so you won't mix Allah Jalla wa Ala and the creation. You won't mix the creation and the creator. If you don't make a distinguish between the two, if you don't know between the two, our tawheed will be weak. Our tawheed will be weak. As for the believers, what is must for him is to worship Allah Jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala and complete his tawheed in whole. To complete his tawheed in whole. So don't have any position. You know, a believer, you don't have any weak or easy position about the people that worship other than Allah Jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala. Indeed they are the enemy of Islam. Indeed they are the enemy of Islam. Indeed they are the enemy of Islam. Because that's the reason why he stayed away from them. He won against them. And he became their enemy. And he won't change his feelings about them. It doesn't matter how close or how far they are to him.
اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد قوموا إلى صلاتكم.